You better love me again. Welcome back, guys, to another video. So Grizzle's channel, today is the day that the ultimate guide is going to be showed. In this video, I have set up the ultimate guide from getting to zero KOs at 400 elo all the way to diamond. Just keep in mind, this is not a guarantee that you will hit diamond, but I guarantee with this, with the this ultimate guide, you will at least be a strong fighter and you're actually gonna get better at the game. So here is how this video is going to work. I'm going to basically go around categories. So at first, I'm gonna explain what you should do at each single elo level. So at before you even able to play ranked, what you should do, what you should focus on. After that, when you get to elo, what you should try and focus on. And then silver, then gold, then etc. etc. Best ways to get better is to always focus on one thing at a time. So I'm going to show you guys the best tips, the best ways to get better, and what you should focus on in the meantime. Remember, this is not going to happen overnight. I know you see some videos from my boy Tom Rhett. Go sub to him, bro. W-mans. There's other YouTubers that did it too. That is hitting diamond in one day. Keep in mind, those guys are experienced fighters and they know how to play the game. And they have a lot of time to kill, so keep in mind it doesn't happen overnight. It always takes a little bit for it to happen. So as you can see, I'm on my alt account because, well, my main account right now is unavailably used. Well, as you can see right now, I'm on my alt account just to kind of show you guys how it goes, how the best ways to learn. For the first part, I'm mainly gonna stay here, but that's okay. But yeah, hope you guys enjoy, and let's get on with the first area that you should focus on, which is the casual. All right, so let's get on with the casual area. So when you're from 0 to 100 KOs in this small little spot right here, I suggest, instead of trying to get better at the game, which of course you have to do, I suggest you have fun. Get used to the game. Do whatever you want. You don't lose elo, you don't lose anything. Just have fun, learn the game. If I have one tip to give you guys, is just practice this little bar right here with timing. So timing your punches, getting used to what the stamina regen is, how healing works when you have your block up. Like, guys, really just have fun and get used to the game. There's no other way to just, you can't just say, oh, it's my first time playing, time to sweat. You know, you have to give it time. You have to start liking the game, and this is the perfect period to see if you're going to like the game or if you're not going to like it. If you're not going to like it, then probably not the game for you. But if you're going to like it, then the next stages and all that are going to be the best things for you. Who should you be fighting in these types of elos? Of course, try and, in every elo, try and play around your elo. But when it's casual, you want to kind of experiment. So for the first few fights, so I'd suggest right now I'm at 15 KOs on this account. For the first, I'd say 10 fights that you play around your elo, so around 400, 600, somewhere there. People that are a little, like, they're on the newer side. So then you'll actually be able to actually learn the game and have some fun. All right, we have found our first match here. 400 to 400. So first part you just got to get used to is your timing. Just get used to that and try and get used to dodging, but it's okay if it doesn't come too early. So here, I'll just show you. You see, I'm not even blocking and I'm able to do something. Don't do what this guy is doing though. Do not do what this guy just did. Let me turn on the audio because that is very loud. So do not do what he just did where you just hold your block and run away. What you want to do is kind of alternate between blocking and attacking. That's what you should be focusing on at the beginning. So I'll just try and be a little slower to kind of show you guys how it works. So as you can see right here, I'm alternating. When I'm not fighting him, I'm blocking. And when I'm attacking, I'm attacking. And just get used to looking at that bar. Get used to dealing 8 damage over time. And trust me, you'll get good. It takes a little bit of time. Keep in mind, I'm very experienced, so it's pretty easy for me. But yeah, just get used to this here and there, and you're gonna get the hang of it. So let me keep getting some fights in. I'll show you guys a little montage of this, and or just a few fights, and yeah. We got baby 0523. Let's see. So yeah, look, go back at it again. alternate between punching and boxing. So you see he's not blocking much. So when he has his block up, try and target his block, because then he'll just be tempted to fight you. Guys, literally using the strategy, I haven't dodged once. Look, I have zero dodges. Like, you could easily get some stuff out of it. And as well, after this, I'm going to show you guys my punch combination. It's on my other video, but I'll show you guys a good punch combination that you want to use for it. So here, I'll show it right now. All right, let me show you guys this combat builder. So if you have, I'm making this builder kind of expecting you to have zero everything. So you have no money, you have no cash that you can spend. So for the power punch, we're going with the uppercut power punch. If, in my opinion, one of the easiest power punch to hide, because if you use a uppercut, then it's very just, you can't notice it as well as other power punches. So block, casual block, idle. This one is more preference for me. I use Philly, but that's your guys' choice. For the punch sequence, for the southpaw or orthodox, it's your choice, but I use southpaw. So the punch sequence is right jab. So as you can see, regular right jab. Whoops, I hit right hook. Right jab. Regular left jab. After that is just regular uppercut, regular right jab, and regular uppercut. A regular just lineup, it should look something like this. It's pretty simple. I like it a lot. So yeah, that should be what you guys should be focusing on. Just try and get better at the game, and yeah, I'm gonna do a few more fights, and then I will try and hit 100 KOs so that I can play ranked. Okay, so for this fight, we're gonna be fighting a 1500 against these guys. Just try and get used to dodging, because they're gonna be a lot more punch heavy than a lot of other fighters. Try and get used to timing your punches. Did you see? Just get better dodges here and there. Don't spam it too much, because stamina is a thing, so just be careful about that, guys. Because stamina, as you can see on the bottom hand of the screen, if that goes down to zero, you cannot punch, you cannot dodge, and if you get power punched in that small period of time, you do get knocked down, which gives a perfect time for your opponent to heal up, and you do not heal up anything in that meantime. So yeah, remember, alternate between punching and attacking, get used to dodging, and you should get better here. Yeah, just get used to timing your punches. It doesn't matter if it's not fast. You just gotta get used to get a rhythm going, and then you should be okay. There we go. The best times to drop your guard and fight is when your block is at zero. In the later spots, especially in silver, which I will show you guys in a second, I will show you guys the best trick to do to get better in that ranked area. Because there's a small little technique that involves blocking and punching that is so useful, y'all, that it's super, that you're gonna use this basically in every fight. So I'm gonna wait until we get to the ranked area before I show you guys that. Alright, guys, I kind of goofed up a lot. So I forgot to let you guys know, they changed the thing so that you don't need 100 KOs anymore to play ranked. So what I said was so, like, out of part. Anyways, basically, the first part basically is just to get used to the game. So, like I said, do what I tell you, time your punches, learn how to alternate between blocking and punching, and get used to dodging, and you should be good. Don't do what this guy is doing and just spamming your punches. This does not get you anywhere. Like, look, it's not really helping you in any way, shape, or form. All right, so now we are in the ranked section of this ultimate guide. In this section, you are going to be playing for Elo. So as you can see, I have an Elo on the bottom of my character, and you'll be fighting to play for that Elo. At 400, I'm not sure if you can go below 400 Elo. But it's very tough to lose your Elo at this Elo. So what I'm going to be doing is more this guy's been trying to fight me. You know what? We're gonna give him the business. But yeah, like I said, just play ranked, play for fun. Do not try and get too hooked onto the game. Don't do what this guy is doing and spamming punches. See, he's alternating. He's doing okay. but he's blocking for too long, so I'm getting free punches off. And when their block is gone is the best time to strike, because they have nothing working for them here. So since the game ended too early, you do not get a single bit of elo, but that is okay. All right, we're gonna play a 1600 here. Let's try and get this win. His block is low, so you can see now I'm just going in for some trades here, because they have a low block. Now I have a low block, so I'm just gonna try and attack his block so his stops regenerating, and then I'm gonna try and trade my punches. There we go. That is well done. So as you could see, in this age, or in this time of space, try and learn to punch and then block right afterwards. I'll show you guys in a second, but best trick to learn is to learn how to punch and then go right back to blocking. So like this, punch, block, punch, block, punch, block. You literally hear my keyboard. You guys have been saying you guys love the ASMR, so I'm giving y'all that ASMR right now. So basically, you just gotta get used to, you know, dodging and just giving yourself some good punches. Just make sure you get used to, you know, the bar on the bottom to make sure it goes down to the 8. So yeah, what I'm saying is you go to block and then you punch and then block right after. Punch, block, punch, block, punch, block. This regenerates your stamina and you are able to block a punch that's coming your way. Good power punch from him, but he's not good enough because I am Die Grizzles. It happens though. So yeah, you just gotta keep fighting and then you'll get better over time. So when you're in this elo level, it's very easy to gain elo. So yeah, look, I got 200 elo like that. So just fight people around your elo. Keep in mind I'm very high level. So yeah, here, I'll fight this 1100. Just fight around your elo, get used to the game, and you should be okay. Well, he just left. Oh, we got the Battle of the Silvers. Oh my god, look at the Battle of the Silvers! Battle of the Silvers! He's down. Alright, we're fighting a 1300. This is very high for people that are just getting into the game, so I suggest, like I said, go to casual matches. And just get used to it. So look, practice hitting those and then go back to your blocking technique. Get used to dodging, because this is probably the time where you're going to have to start sweating a little bit. Because you're playing for stuff now. But at this elo, when you're at 600... you don't gain anything, really. You don't lose anything, sorry, but you gain a lot. So no matter who you fight, if you're in the 400 range, you should be okay. So yeah, I'm just showing you guys here. So just get used to punch blocking. As you can see, I deal a lot of damage to her or him. I don't know. I'm just going to save them. I'm doing a lot of damage to them, and it doesn't hit me because my block is very high, and I'm punch blocking, which is the best way to counter those kinds of players. So as you can see, they left, you get 200 elo, you go on with your day. So I'm guessing in my next game, I will hit 1000, which is silver. So let's go find some. I want to find someone that's more around the 400 range to be more fair. Yeah, just get better, learn how to play the game, and this is the best time to get better at the game. In the early stages is when you test the game, like I said, is to try and get better at the game. So you go like this. The best trip to, I'll show you guys in a, for the silver one, is to try and get better at evading your opponent and give yourself time to recharge. Because look, he's not giving himself any time to recharge, and look, his stamina and health is all the way down because I'm just trading, because I'm going like this the whole time. And when he gets, when I'm low on block, I use my step back, which is F on keyboard and mouse. I forgot what it is on controller. I'll put it up on the screen if I can find it. I believe it's B, I'm not sure. It's B or Y, I forgot. But yeah. Just get used to this, and look, I'm not even dodging anymore, and it's working. You just gotta block, punch, block, punch, block, punch. You block until that little white bar comes back. So you block, you see that 8, punch again. It's pretty simple. For the next elo, though, I'm going to show you the best combos while including dodges. And I will also show you something as well. So you can see you hit 1000, you get new gloves. Because you hit that elo ranking. So let me go to the glove section here. And you get silver gloves, so I'm gonna put them on. Absolute beauties. Look at them gloves. Absolute beauties. Alright, we're now in the silver category, y'all. So we're gonna teach y'all the silver stuff. Let's go to the little gym area, and I'm gonna teach you guys a few things. All right. We are in the gym section. So we are going to be practicing a few little dodge moves or a few little combos to try and get you guys better at the game. So the first combo that I teach you guys, of course, is the punch and then you block. So punch, block, punch, block, punch, block, punch, block, punch, block. And you see that the white bar when I punch here? Wait for it to go all the way down before you punch again. So punch, block, punch, block, punch, block, punch, block, punch, block. So that's literally the only, that's one of the main moves that you're gonna have to use. So then when you get better, you'll just start making it better. You'll start getting quicker and quicker. So just get used to just doing this movement. Do it slowly and then you start getting faster over time and then you'll start getting quicker and quicker. The next moves involve dodges. So of course, the first thing I'm gonna let you guys on a little thing. One of the best dodges to get away is the dodge back. Whenever you do a punch and then you just dodge back, you gain a lot of distance, so you'll be able to regain your block, regain your health. So the thing I'm gonna teach you guys is punch dodging. Punch dodging is one of the most important things in the game, but you can't do it too much. If you do it too much, you're gonna ruin your stamina bar. So punch dodging includes you punching and then dodging right afterwards, but you do it so quickly that you hide your punch animation. So it should look something like this. You heard the bag hit, right? I'll do it one more time. You see that I'm hitting the bag? So that's what punch dodging is. You punch the bag at the same time you step back to or do a dodge to try and dodge the opponent at the same time. A lot of fighters do this a lot, but don't do just this the whole time because then you're just going to ruin your stamina bar. So what I suggest you doing is doing it on occasions. When you feel like the opponent is going to punch you, that's when you do it. So then you'd be like this. You feel like he's punching, oh, this. And then you go back to this. Oh, he's punching again, boom, dodge again. And then whenever you need stamina, you're low on block, step back, run away. You get the idea. It's a lot more combos-like, and in this area, you really got to get better at it to get better at this game. The next thing I'm going to teach you guys with this ELO is power punches. I didn't speak about it a lot. Power punches is the best way to turn the tide of a fight. So a power punch is the is when you press R or the icon that it shows on the bottom if you are on controller or whatnot. Basically, it is a power move which does 25 damage to either your block or your health, depending on which one is open. Be careful though. If their block is below 5, you can hit their power punch even when they're blocking and you'll still deal damage and break their block. If it's a 6 or above, then it will still block and deal 0 damage. So I want you guys to be extremely careful with this power punch and use it wisely so that you guys can deal that 25 damage or deal the max amount of damage on the block as you can. So the best tip that I'm going to show you guys when I go fight is to use your power punch when your opponent or guy has either 0 stamina or has either low stamina or low block, below 5, like I said. So when you get to that low 5 area, this is the best time to unleash the power punch, because if it's low block, then they are at risk of, they're going to get hit, right? Unless they dodge out of it. If they have low stamina, even if you hit their block, they don't have enough stamina to move. And they don't have enough stamina to keep on attacking you, because if you break their block with your power punch, you could just go all in and then you're going to kill them. It's going to be that easy. Wait, the best two scenarios to get those power punches is when they have low stamina, so you can focus on their block and deal them and or get a knockdown if they're very low on stamina. Or whenever they're on low block, so that you'll be able to just deal damage guaranteed unless they dodge. So if both of them are linked together, oh my god, you're landing that thing like 10 times out of 10. Because that is such a broken time to hit power punches. Because if you get a knockdown and you deal that 25 damage, it's over. It's over. You're winning the fight, it's sure. So let's go to the ring and let's get some fights in and try and implement what I just explained now. So now, like I said, play against people that are around your elo. So as you can see, he's 1,000. Hopefully he hops on. There you go. So you could play around people around your elo. So right there, this is probably the most even fight we've had all day. So just try and get used to, you know, punch dodging and punching. So you can see I feel like he's going to punch. I get a dodge animation. And then you go back to blocking. You go try and break their block. You see their block is broken, so now you're being aggressive. He has no block, I go for the power punch. It's that easy. It's a lot of mental thinking. You think that this game is a lot more... you guys may think that this game is very just spammy and you don't have to really use strategy to win. I think not. In this game, I believe there's a lot of strategy that's involved with this type of fighting. You can easily get way better with just trying to get better. So back to punch dodging. Get back to this punch dodge. So you see I back up. Now he's forced to fight me because he wants to get trades very badly. He's spamming a lot, so I'm just going to try and get some easy punches here. He has a low block, so I'm going to go for the power punch. He dodged it, but that's okay. He still has zero block. I'm just going to try and dodge his punches because I just dodged his power punch, if you guys didn't notice. But yeah, very useful moves, and you should be able to win most of your fights with these types of techniques. So you see back away, he's forcing onto me, so now I have a bigger lead, so I'm going to try and be more aggressive. I'm going to try and dodge his moves. I'm going to regain my block here because I have no block. He's very aggressive. I'm going to force a power punch because he has low stamina. And yep, as you can see, he had very low stamina, so I just poured it. Even if I didn't hit him specifically, I hit his block, which I was able to break, therefore dealing more damage on the long run. So he hit my power punch, so I'm going to just try and be a little more dodgy so I can wait for my my block to come back. One issue I see a lot of players do in when they're new to the game is they hold their block a little bit too long. As you can see right here, he's holding his block too long, so I could just break it and then I could just get a kill right there. So be careful, guys, when it comes to actually using when it comes to actually blocking, because you got to be careful. You can't just, you know, hold it out for too long, because then your block's gonna die and then you won't be able to come back. So just make sure that you get used to dropping your guard and then fighting until it comes back. You should look above your screen. It has the block meter. Just wait for it to come around 3/4 up and then you should be good. All right, we'll go around another round here. So just practice this. Against players that don't dodge, you don't really need to dodge either. Because they won't be playing like this. So like you can see my block is low. I'm going to let it recharge before... when they're far away, you can hold your block up because then it will make you regenerate health. Right there, that was a terrible power punch for me. As you can see, he still had 8 health. I did the power punch. I killed his block, but it didn't give me any... It didn't deal any damage because his block was too high. So yeah, don't do what this guy is doing. Don't spam your punches. Just time them well. And then even if you don't even use anything, you will be just fine. So as you can see, one again, I'm at 1300. You can see it's pretty easy to climb up the ranks when you go from bronze to gold. So like I said, I will guarantee you that you will hit 1500 if you follow these tips. But diamond, that's you guys. You guys got to play your heart out to hit diamond. So I'm going to show you guys the tips, but I'm probably not going to hit it today because it's still very tough to hit it. But yeah, let's try and hit some a gold rank right here and it will go crazy. You can see he's a little bit more dodge heavy, so you can see he has no stamina anymore, so I'll just break his block. Oh, he dodged my... You can see he's very dodge heavy. This is not good. Look at his stamina compared to mine. I really just outworked him when he had zero stamina. So this is why you have to be a little bit... You have to be very careful with your stamina usage. It's so annoying when you fight people that are... super dodge heavy, but it's so easy to play because you just let them do their thing. You just try and time your punches and you'll just do your thing. It's okay. All right, we have our fight against Baldy 2. We are going to try and get better out of the game. So you can see he's on the spamming side. So if they spam, so they just spam click, you can see another one of those dodge players. You got to just let him go crazy and you just got to get out of his way. You can see right now he's just going back against the wall, wasting his block for no reason. He's not blocking, so I'm just going to go for the power punch. And that is another round. And since they left, it doesn't give me an elo, which is slightly annoying. But I think we're fighting the same guy as earlier. Eh, that's okay. It's the best way to teach you guys because it shows that you can be very good. You can be a lot of good players even if you're on a lower rank. very aggressive fighter here. So I'm going to focus his block because then he won't be able to do anything with it. He has no block. All right, he's spamming a lot. So I'm just going to back up a bit, regain my block here before I go back in. So you can see my block is back. So I'm going to go and force his block down. Bada bing. So yeah, you can see you just really attack their block and then you should be okay. Against higher ranks though, you're going to need to be a lot more on your A game. So you got to be a lot more dodgy. You got to be a lot more careful with what moves you take and don't take. So you can see now I have low stamps. I'm going to let myself regain. I'm going to back up. He's going to be a bit more aggressive. So I'm just going to go back to trading. He did a power punch there, so I have no block. So I'm going to try and run away to get my block back up. He's not going to fight me. Right here, he does have low health, so I'm going to break his block with my power punch. And then I'm going to try and just finish him off, dealing more damage in the long run. Broke his block again. And bada bing, bada boom, he's down. So yeah, guys, just get used to this. And for the gold rank, I'll just show you guys a few games and then show you guys a few tips. And then for diamond, I'll just explain it to you guys. Because diamond is a whole different specimen. This one, he's playing better than I am. So I'm just going to power punch him right there because he's always super aggressive. And bada bing, bada boom, we win another fight. So guys, just be confident in yourself. You guys are going to be okay. People are like this every day. So you just got to get better and that's all. I guess I'm fighting him again. He just wants to fight me again. Once again, get used to dodging. It's probably the main thing you should learn in this age, in this area. Get used to dodging. Get used to timing your dodges so that you dodge their punch and not just dodge the air. And this is very simple, guys. It's not rocket science or anything. It's very simple stuff. Anyone can do this. Mobile, Xbox, everyone can do it. If you guys want to watch a player that hit diamond on controller when he's a PC player, go to Tom Red's video. He has a very good video of him hitting diamond on controller. And he's very aggressive, so I'm just gonna pop his health right there with an uppercut. So yeah, if you guys could hit diamond on any device, there's a lot of players, surprisingly, that are diamond and they're mobile players. So guys, literally, anyone can hit diamond if they want to. Just gotta get work. You gotta put the work in, and you guys gonna get hit. And bada bing, bada boom. We got 1444. We are almost at the big gold rank. All right, we're gonna fight this guy 1700. Against these higher guys when they're 1700 and above, you have to be a lot more careful. Because they know a lot more. So you got to be a lot more dodgy. You got to be a lot more shifty. You got to be less predictable. So I'm going to fake it. I'm going to pretend I'm going to go in. So then he punches. He's not that guy. So I'm going to target his block. He holds his block for too long. So best thing to do against these types of fighters is be aggressive. If they hold their block for too long and they don't want to fight you back, then just forecheck him and you're going to be chilling. So here, what you can see, he's... I don't know why he's flexing. So you can see he's holding his block for too long. So I'm just going to be aggressive. I have no blocks. I'm going to let myself recharge. He's just going to be aggressive because he thinks he has an opportunity. He does not, though, because I know how to dodge my way out of fights. I did a bad power punch. I was trying to kill his block because his health was low. But yeah, just try and get better at timing your punches. And there we go. We have one. We have 1487. Next game should be my rank up game to the gold rank. And then I will teach you guys the do tricks in the gold rank to try and get better. My man doing the lean channel challenge. Look at him. He's leaning. He is leaning, my guy. How you doing, Bruski? How you doing? All right. This is for the gold rank. We are fighting a man named King. So, yeah. We have to remember. You got to use what you learned. So, you got to use your block. He is spamming a lot more, but he is blocking a lot. So, I'm going to re-heal my block. I'm going to be a bit more aggressive, use my punching technique, block, dunge, block, punch, block, punch. I have no block now, so I'm going to back up. He's being aggressive when he has no health, so I'm just going to uppercut him next on the other side of the ring. So yeah, just get used to this kind of rhythm, guys. Get used to your rhythm, and then in gold rank, I'm going to explain you guys one small trick but it's going to get you guys super good. There, it was a beautiful power punch from him. He's very aggressive, so I'm just going to power punch him so he has no block. He is not... I think he's in disbelief. There we go. And, hey, we have gone the gold rank, which means we have the gold gloves. And, yep, so equip both. We got to equip both gloves. And, beautiful, we have the gold gloves. In the gold rank, I'm going back to the gym, and I'm going to be speaking more than showing you guys stuff, because all it is now is amplifying everything I told you, but figuring out the way you play the game. Let me explain. When you play this game, you are... Of course, there's so many different ways you could fight in this game. There is, of course, aggressive. There is very block, attacking their block, attacking their health, attacking, being defensive, trading. There's so many strategies you can take to try and get better at this game. The main thing you gotta learn is figuring out your playstyle and sticking to it. So, personally, I see myself as an aggressive fighter right now. Aggressive defensive fighter. So I'm going to be a lot more aggressive at times, and then I'll back up to let myself heal up, get my block, get my health up, etc. The best ways, I'll teach you guys the best ways to play for all these playstyles. So aggressive, trading is the most important thing for aggressive fighters. Let me explain to you what trading is. Trading is basically you're getting hit, they're hitting you for a block, but you're hitting them for damage. You remember that little, this trick right here to block, dodge, block, punch, block, punch? That is what trading is. You punch them, then you block right away so that they hit you for damage, and then you hit them right back for health. That is what trading is. It is so important in the high ranks that if you trade perfectly, you're going to win every game. So, you got to hit them with this. You got to do this to try and get better, and then you got to get better at dodging. You got to time your dodges better and focus on that trading. For some aggressive fighters, they will target the block more. So what they will do is they'll double up their punches. They'll do this. They'll double up their punches. They'll try and hit you twice so that they'll hit you for health plus your block if you do block twice. If not, you're just dealing 12 damage to either your block or 10 damage or 12 damage to your health or 10 to your block. So it's a win-win either way, but it gives them a wider opening for them to get hit. So defensive fighters are going to be a lot happier to fight these kinds of players. That is how you play aggressive. You got to be careful. You got to be a lot more aggressive. You got to be more in the person's face so that they can't regen their stamina, they can't regain their block, and they have always low health. So that's how you fight aggressively. Now for the defensive players, I suggest you get better at trading, of course, because trading is like the most important thing. The best thing you got to do is get better at dodging. Dodging is going to be so important. So against defensive players, they'll be a lot more away, and then you got to get better at this punch dodge technique, especially with the step back, because then you're just backing away from your opponent, and you're going to have to try and get a little bit more shifty so you can shift one way to another and then back up. So of course, be careful with your stamina, because that is very dangerous. It's a very dangerous type of player, so it's like a high risk, high reward, because this is the player that will take the longest time to win, but he'll win. That's what I'm trying to say. Aggressively trying to end the fight as quickly as possible. Defensive, he's taking his time and finding his moment to win. So just try and get better at this technique, and if you're defensive, and you should get better. Of course, you could find your own little technique and get in between, but I think those are the two most bigger techniques that you gotta get better. So what did we learn? Get better at trading, get better at block punching. So you gotta block, punch, block, punch, block, punch. Get better at that little technique. Get better at timing your dodges so that when you'll actually dodge their opponent's attack. Have fun at the game, of course, and take your time. You don't have to rush anything. You could just have yourself a grand old time. And that is basically what Boxing Beta is all about. It's meant to be a game. It's meant to make you have fun. It's not meant to you to throw your controller outside the room. So yeah, just make sure you guys have fun, and that is how you guys should get out of gold. And of course, fight people around your elo. If you don't feel comfortable fighting elo, then fight in casual. You can always fight in casual. It's your choice. Nobody will be mad at you if you don't fight in elo. But yeah, that's basically that for the gold rank. And for Diamond, it's about perfection. That's all I can say. It's all about learning new things. It's all about trying to perfect certain techniques. It's all about being perfect on blocking. Make sure you drop your guard at the best time possible so it can regen. It's knowing when you should block, when you should not block, when you should dodge, when you should double up, when you should time your punches, etc., etc. It's all about timing those. If you guys want to be amplify your game to the next level, I suggest you join the NBA, which is my training camp with, well, I'm a coach in it, so I'm going to be helping you guys get better at it. But yeah, that's basically all the tips to try and get better. Basically, from gold, from around 1800, or from 1500 to 19 to 1800, you're learning a lot. You're learning a lot more than you think. So remember, y'all, have fun, take your time. It doesn't happen overnight. So yeah, just try and get better at the game, and it happens, yo. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this little tips tutorial. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe. If you guys would like to join the NBA, link in the description of this video. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, guys.